Darrpan, thank you for creating this. Thank you for giving platform to this new thing. But I want to know, what are we doing? Where are organized casting agencies for voice? This has to be sorted out.
Vaibhav, if I may start with you, being an animator, very interesting because, you know, almost everyone harbors a dream to be a voice of an animated character. It's perhaps one of the first dreams all of us grow up with as children, right? So, Vaibhav, if you would like to tell our audience what it takes to be the voice of an animated character, what do you look for? And how do you go about hiring? I think it's very important for a lot of people here to know, especially the newcomers, what do the hirers look for, you know, and what does it take, really?
Couple of things that I feel that what I had also faced in my initial years is that on a student level, we take our portfolio very lightly. We think ki yaar koi na koi kaam de hi dega. You know, and we rely on Uparwala, this is that. But a lot of homework is required. I think a lot of seniors might agree with me that when you look at a person's reel, even for 5 seconds, first 5 seconds, you immediately come to know where this talent is going to go. You know, so what as a professional we also look at is we go through a lot of show reels when we are designing a character, and we have our sound coordinators. Unfortunately, a lot of directors, film directors, producers, they don't have time to personally go and hunt for the talent. So a lot depends on our trust on the sound producer who is hunting the talent for us. So we have to depend on him, and he has to depend on the showreels that he receives. So that creates your first impression. And secondly, hota kya hai ki, everybody says you are as good as your last job. Yes, completely agree. But even your first job is also very important. Like your first impression is also very important. So my first advice would be like work on your showreel. You know, that is something that creates an impression.
Tip number one, showreel.
We spend a lot of time showroom mein jaake hum log kaun sa shirt pehnne ka, kaun sa kya pehnne ka. We ask for like 20 options. But when we are sending our work to somebody, chalna ye kal raat ko banaya hai, render mara, ye jo bhi hai, record kar liya, bhej dena, dekhte kya hota hai. That casual attitude is no more, I think, because there's too much of competition and there's too much of talent, and we want more talent. So we keep looking for more talent, but for us to judge, the only way to save time of our clients is to go through their showreels.
And as a creator, how much does the voice contribute, and how much do you rely on the voice to create that character?
मैं तो सिर्फ एक ही बात बोलूँगा जब हम लोग किसी को बोलते हैं which industry you belong to, and we say we belong to audiovisual industry, that itself is a definition. Audio comes first, visual comes later.
True that. Tip number two, you are the most important person.
And also, I don't know how much time I have, but
you
I
do.
Couple of things that I always think, like, you know, I listen to a lot of inspirational speeches, and I try to grasp few things which I can put into my work. And regarding voice, only couple of things, like what Rahul also said, you know, the voice is not important.
You Absolutely.
Know, I remember what Osho, I believe some of you know what Osho, who Osho was. Osho said, I give speeches, but my words are not important. The important thing is the pause in between the word, because that's when I speak. So I think that is very important for us to understand, like where the negative space lies, how to fill it up, you know, how gracefully to present yourself. That is the most important thing.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Vaibhav. Rahul, you have now started out on a journey that is really, 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 really boundless in terms of where one can go with audiobooks. And audiobooks has become such a massive, massive and important market, especially for voices and for audiences. Would you like to tell us what you look for when you're hiring voices and how you go about your casting?
Whenever we get a book to record, we just go through the book, we understand the gist and the synopsis of that book, and we first of all categorize it in between the voice age and the gender, and then we decide on how to cast and when, whom to cast for a particular book. So if you to give you a very precise example, we did a book called Hindu, and it was a very controversial book written by Bhalchandra Nembhadi. And I was very skeptical while casting for that particular book, and then I thought that I should cast somebody who has got that similar thoughts about the book. It is not anti-Hindu or it is not anti any religion, but it is it goes to the core level of Hinduism and everything. So accordingly we decide, and accordingly we have a panel discussion amongst ourselves, and then we decide whom to cast and who should narrate the book.
And you also have a requirement, again a very diverse requirement there, in terms of certain books which need only narrators, whereas certain books that require a lot more voice acting and characterization.
Yes.
So, do you cast accordingly?
Our research says that when a book is narrated very in a passive manner, or it is just...
If it's just a narration.
It's just a narration, people are not enjoying that. This is what our research says, and when we have so much talented people in voicing industry, they do characterizations, they perform different characters on mic, and which is absolutely amazing, and that is giving us the most response, and which is why those kind of books are doing well on the app.
Nice. So I think that's an important learning from this, is that ultimately everything is voice acting, no matter what we think it is.
Yes, plain narration is not liked by anybody, and when they act and when they get the character out of their voicing, it sounds really nice.
Yeah, and do you find it easy to find the voices that you're looking for? You think there's enough and more out there?
No, it's not easy.
It isn't.
It is not easy. Yeah. No. It takes time. Sometimes a particular book takes approximately 2 months to finalize the voice, to get the voice approval. It's okay. Not easy. No.
Agreed. And sometimes we're given only 1 month to finish production.
Yes, 1 month.
So what? Casting, recording, yes. Editing, mixing, everything. It's a very tight turnaround, isn't it?
Tight turnaround, and we have to be on our schedule, and so we have to have a catalog. We have release dates on our program, so we have to wind up everything before that.
Yeah, and something that's very important for you specifically, and that I find as a voice trainer, is that very often we are teaching people to read, not to speak. Someone who's a very good reader ultimately ends up being a very good speaker, because they're able to deal with the words more effortlessly and therefore put their entire attention on the speaking part.
Right, so we have faced that there's few narrators who are extremely very good and talented voiceover artist.
Yeah.
But when it comes to reading, they tend to fumble a bit, but then they do their homework. They take the copy of the book along their
home. Yes, that's necessary for an audiobook.
They study the book, they come prepared, which is where we save our time, and the output is really awesome.
Yeah, that's excellent. So for an audiobook, preparation is required, unlike some of our other areas of voicing.
Yes.
That's nice.
It can't be impromptu.
Yeah, it can't be impromptu. Thank you. Sumanto, you've done some great, great work on radio productions. But as a radio producer, again, you're hiring a plethora of voices across genres. So you're going from promo voices to voiceovers to radio presenters to voice actors for your drama. So how do you find the talent pool, and how do you go about casting and hiring?
So I'll first focus on the radio dramas, because voice acting is something which we are talking about. Being from a corporate, what happens is, of course, we try to do a lot of new things, new innovations, sometimes repackage things in a way that the presentation is different. But we also have a challenge that if we're spending a certain amount of money to create a production, it has to sell. We should have sponsors. So then the casting becomes a little more difficult for us. So I remember when 10, 11 years back, when I did Ramayan on radio, so you know how the corporates, they speak, bada banana hai, kuch bada karte. So now what is Bada is very difficult to understand. So the reason I decided Ramayan was it's a heard story. People can relate to it. It's easy to, you know, relate because they have seen it.
All grown up with it.
Grown up with
it.
So then came the most difficult thing, casting. And I believe as a director, I've worked in visual, I have directed ad films also, serials also. And in the whole period of learning, I've learned one thing. If you have casted correctly, you have won 80% of your battle.
Fantastic.
80%
That's so
of the battle
true.
Is
That's
done
so
if
true.
You have done your casting properly. So we did a mixed bag. We got some of the Bollywood stalwarts. We had Javed Bhai playing Hanuman. I had Nasir Saab playing Ravan. Om Puriji was the narrator of that play. Anupam Kher was Dashrath. And there were many more. Ratna Pathakji played a character. Mantra she played. And then, again, a question was asked, who would play Ram, Sita and Lakshman? They are the protagonist. So then I took a decision and I said, we will get these artists from theatre and voice industry. People who are not, who are popular in the industry, but not popular among the, you know, public, among the listeners. The reason was I wanted my Ram and my Sita and my Lakshman in people's mind, the way they see those gods in their idols, in their calendar at home. I didn't want them to imagine Amir Khan or Shah Rukh Khan as Ram.
Since you mentioned Ramayan, I think what really strikes me here is that when you deal with a tale that's been told so many times in so many different ways by so many different people, how do you maintain the integrity of the characters and still do something different? Like, how can each actor bring something new, like a new dimension to that character without only going by a preconceived notion of that character? Because no one's ever actually heard these people speak. Whatever we think they speak like has been created by someone in the past.
I have to sound logical. Right. So the first thing we did is we humanized the characters.
Right.
Ram, Bhagwan nahi, wo aapke aur mere jaise ek insaan hai jinme Bhagwan jaise power thi. So first, believe in the characters. Ravan was evil. और कौन सा evil यार बात करने के बाद हा 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 करके हंसते हैं मेरे को आज तक समझ नहीं आया I have never got it and that's how we started you know clicking together with Nasir same thing happened with JJ also when JJ said यार हनुमान कॉमेडी होगा मैंने कहा नहीं होगा and he said मैं मुझे कॉमेडी नहीं करना मैंने कहा हनुमान कॉमेडी नहीं है वो प्यारा है he is innocent और कॉमेडी में डिफरेंस है When he understood that, he did it and how he did it. Put unexpected thing in front of the audience, they love it.
They love to
be surprised. That's what the whole thing about.
Excellent. Jyothi, you bring a very, very different dimension to this panel. First of all, your designation, you know, VP Global Localization. Now, localization is a very new term in today's world. Would you like to tell everybody what is localization and what are the different forms?
Sure. You all say voiceover, dubbing and everything, right? Localization basically nothing means you are localizing a particular content to your local audience. We've been historically, you know, seeing dubbed UK English, US English coming into, you know, UK and English, US content coming into India. But in the last 2-3 years, we have seen content coming from across the globe, right?
Yes.
My team has done some good job on South Korean, Indonesian content dubbed into Hindi. You know, that's the kind of localization or dubbing that we're offering to people. And it's not just one language. Stories are going global. You know, globalization is what is expected over the next 2 years. If I have to tell you, dubbing industry in India, probably about 3 decades, entire revenue of dubbing industry is probably about 150 crores a year.
Today.
Right. But that's less than one big banner movie.
Absolutely.
Right? And which means it's just at the, you know, tip of the iceberg in India. Right? And we can go global. It's whether it is Sacred Games or Part of Blood, which is going viral across the globe, or international content coming into India, right? So that's localization, you know, from one language go to, you know, multiple languages. That's what we believe in, localization.
And until now, clients were usually, you know, crunching numbers and saying we'll go through subs and dubs are too expensive. Do you see that scenario changing rapidly? Happily so?
I won't say that, because, you know, it has its own flavor, dubs as well as subs. And obviously, you know, it depends upon the content owner. If I produce a movie and I don't have a big budget, I would probably just say dubbing baad mein karenge, pehle subtitle dal denge, right? So that's the content owner's perspective. But Netflixes of the world are changing it completely, okay? And if you look at even in terms of voiceover talent niche or what we call it, like their quality of voice and everything that is available in the industry, the customers are saying, okay, I need to not just see the voice talent, but I need to see everything else that is available in the dubbing process. Whether it is a dubbing director, who's the sound engineer, what's their profiles, and everything, right? So I would say it's again depending upon the content owner, what is the budget on the content, where is it being, you know, going to be in the market. Like if Netflix probably wanting to spend it because they're going global, right? If you look at an international content coming into India, you might probably want to test the waters with just Hindi first. And then the two other languages with Tamil and Telugu. But now, you know, it's going, right? It's like sky is the limit.
They want to straight away come in with 3, 5, and 7 languages.
Exactly.
Yeah. And that's interesting, because now that's resulted in our ecosystem falling too short of the requirement. So how are we dealing with training, recruiting, hiring fresh talent in all of these all parts of the process, basically?
Sure, you said it all. It's a double-edged sword. While customers, I mean, there's huge demand with respect to voice talent in India. At the same time, customers are becoming very, very picky. They don't want repetitive voices. They're like, you know, kali sunata na us episode mein, I don't want to hear the same voice again, right? So how do you get new talent into the industry? You guys are doing amazing job, especially the, you know, veterans of the industry are coming up with, you know, training newer talent, bringing them into the industry. Schools are being, you know, open just to nurture them, train them. Sometimes I would say, you know, it's not just the voice, right? It's the talent, or, you know, how do you exhibit your voice? You know, how do you enact? How do you, you know, you need to be an actor to be a voice artist. It's just not the voice at all.
So for all these voices, or maybe I'll come to that actually, because I think that's something that all of us can think about, is what can they do to cut through the crowd and make themselves attractive to hirers is something I think we should close with. So that gives you something to think about. Meanwhile, if I can move on to Kashif. Now you're dealing with advertising primarily, right? So advertising always has seen like a very a small talent pool servicing the entire industry, and everybody wants to work within their comfort zone with the people they're comfortable with, the voices they're comfortable with. Almost half the, I'd say 80 or 90% of the new talent, that aspiring voices that come to me, say, I want to be a voiceover. They don't always understand what that means. And everybody thinks that, okay, advertising is it, that's where all the money is. And films is where the glamour is. And animation is where the fun is. So how do you think that, you know, newcomers can break through this whole little comfort zone that all the directors and producers have with the existing voice talent?
So I don't, you know, I think that there's a, I don't completely agree with that, because I think more and more everybody is looking for fresher talent. It's like a thing that almost comes from the ad agencies, like, okay, we've heard these guys, we've worked with them forever, now who's new? And I think that, you know, there's this lack of representation for voice talent. Like, everybody else has agents, has, you know, like people that represent them. But as far as voicing and voice artists goes, you have to really find them, and you have to like dig this out, you know, you have to find this new voice. So eventually you want to go try it and test it, because you don't have time in advertising.
Exactly.
You don't have time, you just have like, the turnarounds are much quicker and much faster, and there's no time to research really. But yeah, I mean, if you had sources of finding these people, then I think it would be much easier and much quicker.
Right. And do you find that voice talent is able to break through more easily now?
I think so. I mean, there are a lot more younger directors. There are a lot of young production houses, you know, and they really want to hear fresh.
They also tend to experiment with the people in the room,
yeah.
Right?
I mean, they really, I mean, like...
Every director is saying, "Arey, go on the mic."
Yeah, go on the mic, try it. I mean, there are creative, you know, the copywriters who are just giving the voices themselves. Yeah. You know, that keeps changing. It's like it's evolving, you know. I don't think that it's static.
Is that primarily to get freshness?
I think so, yeah. I mean, like, how much can you hear of the same voice? I mean, it's completely legitimate, you know. I feel like it's not wrong, whilst, you know, the veterans are where they are, and there are certain things that just they can do. You need that freshness.
You cannot undermine that.
Yeah, you can't undermine that.
Cannot
but then
undermine
there's this whole new avenue that's coming in. Yeah.
So this brings me to two questions that I think I'd like all of you to answer, which I think is very relevant for every person in this room. First of all, for a newcomer, what can they do to cut through the crowd and be noticed? You know, what can they do for people to say, okay, that's the one. Right? And for those of us who have been around forever and feel like fossils in this industry, what can we do to reinvent ourselves and just stay, hang in there?
The first thing is, see, you have to start somewhere. So it's very good to have big dreams, you know, one day I'll be somewhere and I'll get paid so much. The problem with the new generation is they really want to have something that comes very quick to them.
Yeah.
You know, just like downloading app. ऐसा कोई करियर सिलेक्ट करो और बन जाओ कुछ करो. They don't realize that art form, any art form, may it be dance, may it be singing, may it be animation or painting, you have to give time. You have to give time to rehearse, practice, and to make yourself perfect. So just slow down a little bit. That's my first advice. Slow down. Look at yourself. Analyze your work. You know. Be a critic, be a big critic of your work, you know. Don't you know, I never work so that people applaud for my work. I always think, yes, koi to koi mera animation mein koi to nooks nikalega, but then I'll correct it next time. You won't be able to point it. So, apne nooks nikalne ko jo pehle sikhega, jo apni galtiyan pehle accept karke usko quickly correct karega, I think that is the demand of the time today. And secondly, sometimes you don't have to invest, you know, too much on your softwares, or I don't have this mic which creates that depth. I live in Lucknow, Kanpur. वहाँ पे कोई सुनता नहीं है. So first thing is, make your showreel. Go. अगर प्यास लगी है तो पहले कुआं ढूँढो. खोदो मत. पहले कुआं ढूँढो. कैसा यहाँ पे क्यों पानी है? कैसा पानी मिलता है? कैसे निकालेगा? Learn all that. Learn all that. Do it for free. You know, knowledge. If you're getting it for free, take it.
Absolutely.
Good or bad, take it. You know, don't think ye sahi hai ya galat hai. Just take that knowledge, then you analyze. Ghar pe jaake. Do that and be prepared for working hard. 24 hours a day. Lot of people get up so late and, you know, chit chat and all that. Get up and just start thinking about your work. Be a workaholic. That's it.
Thank you. Rahul.
for a newcomer that to stand out and be somebody, a star among the entire bunch of people, it's not possible. It is going to take time, it is going to take years, efforts and everything. Nothing is going to happen in a couple of years or 3 years. Okay, I was a newcomer one day. Nobody still knows me that much, but I was a newcomer. And we have temples in Mumbai where there are gods like Ellie and Greta, right? We have somebody like Sean. We have somebody like, we know who did Rani Mukherjee and Bipasha Basu as well, right? So the only thing that will make you great is only practice. You have to watch, this is how I learned, by people going on mic. I observed what are the nuances, what are the techniques, what counts to be a voiceover artist. You can take a training for a month or a couple of months, but you will not be an established voiceover artist until and unless you continuously go on mic and do practice.
Absolutely. There's no fast food and no replacement for hard work and the time and effort you put in.
Mona, I have a different perspective to it. Okay. We are expecting too much from the newcomers. We expect them to learn, we expect them to do this, do that, make showreels, everything.
And we don't want to frighten them today.
Darrpan, thank you for creating this. Thank you for giving platform to this new thing. But I want to know, what are we doing? Where are organized casting agencies for voice? This has to be sorted out. That's my question, that's my problem. As a director, I find difficult to... Actually, I wanted to compete for the contest. Jury bana ke bitha de hai, mere t-shirt de raha hai. But you know what? These kind of things has to be more organized. We have to be producers, directors, voice actors, senior veteran voice actors. We have to, you know, come up with some plan where we can do workshops free of cost. Please understand, people have come from Jaipur, Chandigarh, Bhopal. Yes. They won't have money to come and, you know, do expensive courses. Can we do something for them? Then we expect them to make a showreel or do anything. Can we create casting agencies? I worked with Mr. Sunil Shetty last year in a project, and he runs one casting agency called FDC,
F the Couch.
I discussed this problem with him also. We created for that project, I did one whole audition thing. I created a separate,
voice bank.
Yeah. This thing. And now we are working towards, Mr. Shetty has promised me that he is going to create a separate tab on the website for voice talent.
Excellent.
But can we do it more? Can bigger casting agencies can come and have a separate casting for them? Where do these people go?
Right.
Knock the studio doors. They are soundproof.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So I think first we have to look into our responsibilities. We need them as much as they need us.
Absolutely.
We need to understand.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Well, let me answer that from a demand gen perspective.
Absolutely.
That's when you see the demand in the market, and that's when you need new talent and all. I come all the way from Bangalore. We hear three things in Bangalore: AI, ML, and the third one, anybody can guess?
MT.
Job loss.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
But let me tell you, friends, the third word, we are very, very, very safe. All of us in the room here, okay? Because dubbing industry in Mumbai just started in India.
Absolutely.
Okay? There is so much to do, so much to, you know, learn, so much to discover and cover and all that. Now, with that, if you're a new artist, you obviously have that kid in your head that, you know, I need to learn something else other than just the voice, because I don't know where I would be after 10 years, right? I have lived abroad. I know global trends a little bit. What happens in the international market is, you know, I was listening to somebody who was telling her, do baje voice clip bech dena, right? In India, as Sumanto rightly said, we don't have a marketplace where the voice talent can cast their voices. Nobody has to, you know, call up anybody and say, hey, send me your voice clip, right? And that's going to come very soon in the industry. Okay, that's one part of it. And if, with respect to voice talent, I'm sure everybody, you know, tells you guys, hone your skills, talk in front of the mirror, start acting, you know, all of that. But if you ask me, I would probably give you a couple of tips. One, probably learn another language, because we're going global.
Yes.
Neutral English is going to be a need of Indian dubbing industry. Right now, for Indian English, we have very less people.
Yes.
Okay? And second, probably learn a little bit of technology, because audio description is picking up.
Yes.
So is many other narration-related voiceovers.
Yes.
You know, just the one single narration, right? You don't need to have 10 different people in the team to do this.
Yeah.
You just need to learn a little bit of technology, you know, punch in, punch out, and then you go to the studio by yourself and get done with the job, and you can.
Which is what a lot of the audiobook narrators are doing themselves.
Exactly. Work from home. That's my suggestion.
I know Rishi works from home. Don't you? Yeah.
Yes. So that's my suggestion. So again, you know, nobody becomes a veteran in the industry overnight. Nobody becomes a sensation, right? Unless you are very lucky.
Yeah.
You just need to have that patience and work hard. You will get there someday. All of us.
Excellent. Kashif.
Yeah. So I spoke about representation in the previous question. So yeah. I think that remains. But apart from that, I think Vaibhav covered. You know, I don't know how many kids have the workaholic ethic.
Oh yeah.
You know, I don't like, because mine's a fairly young production company, so I'm dealing with kids all the time.
Yeah.
And so many leave us along the way because they just can't hack, you know, the hours or the drills, you know, the motions. So I think it's the fine balance between this and that. Of course, they need representation. They need a place to go to, and you know, and somebody to drive their talent. But apart from that, then they've got to stick it out.
Yeah. So what we did last year is we launched an app here called the Voice Directory, and it was a soft launch just for our colleagues to see how it works. And we got a lot of feedback after which I have this to say: please delete it from your phones, because we have to come up with a completely new version of it. The requirements are changing fast. It needs to have many more features. It needs to have exactly what you're saying in terms of the way talent, how easy it is to find talent on there. So we are working towards it. The voice directory lives on, but for the moment, please delete it from your phones because it needs a new lease of life. So we are working towards that, exactly this, that, you know, so many people came to me for training, and I was disillusioned after a while that, you know, why am I training people if I can't get them a job? So, and is it really my responsibility alone to get them a job? Or is it a collective industry responsibility, both the voice's responsibility to make themselves attractive, as well as a hirer's responsibility to go out there and be able to find that voice? So this is what we were trying to achieve, and we still are trying to achieve. And we feel that once somebody has had training, they need a platform to showcase their skills, where somebody can just log in and you know, go through some search options and some filters to find the right voice.
You know, one thing which definitely I would like to share with the new talent pool who are trying to come into the voice industry. Today, what I saw, I was part of the jury when this new voice talent came, they performed. One point which I'll definitely direct you towards is
first find your own voice before imitating anybody else. The problem is, everybody who came here, other than one girl, everybody was imitating somebody. Understand, if Rajesh Gava is playing a monkey, he has created that voice. Reason, he knows his voice. He knows his bass, his mids, his highs, he knows everything about his voice. Until and unless you understand your own voice first, then comes imitating anybody or, you know, like example of Mr. Shashidhar.
Yes.
The reason that
is Chetan here? Chetan's not here. Okay.
The reason that man can come up with so many voices and reinvent every time is because he knows his voice.
Yes.
It's important. Subah se hum sunte aa rahe hain bass kharab cheez nahi hai. लेकिन ज्यादा भारी जो है ना इस समंदर में डुबो देगा कैरेक्टर लेके आई है वो इसमें मैं जब कास्टिंग करता हूँ मैं कैरेक्टर ढूंढता हूँ मेरा लक्ष्मण या मेरा भरत या मैंने अभी रिसेंटली महाभारत की इट वॉज मैसिव कास्टिंग लाइक इट वॉज डिफिकल्ट टू बिकॉज महाभारत इज फॉर ऑडियो प्ले इट्स वन सीन वुड हैव 15 कैरेक्टर्स एवरीबडी स्पीकिंग
You can't tell who's who.
You can't tell who's... You have to have a different character in the voice. Imagine everybody sounding like Bachchan sahab. Bhishma Pita bol raha hai, kya ho raha hai? Arjun bhi bol raha hai, ye ho raha hai. Will you find any difference? No. Find a character. Find yourself. Find your voice. Then train it.
And that's a fantastic, fantastic note to wrap this one up on. Thank you, Vaibhav. Thank you, Rahul. Thank you, Sumanto. Thank you, Jyothi. And thank you, Kashif. And I think that's the most important takeaway from today's panel is to find your voice.